So I feel like shit today. As you can probably tell from this, I've been sick the whole weekend. And it sucks. Because I wanted to do so much. I plan on doing so much, and I'm sick. And I've got an ear infection, so it feels like someone's drilling into my skull. It feels awesome. So what do I do when I'm sick? I drink green tea out of a Game of Thrones cup. I wear my teddy bear hat. As you should. This video is gonna be about this little album. Yeah, that I'm holding in my hands. This is requested. And it's gonna be a review on this album. 30 Seconds to Mars, right? You know them? Their album, Love, Lust, Faith, and Dreams. So let's start off with the front cover. The front cover is a very famous painting by an artist called Damien Hirst. It's his dot painting. Now, a lot of the Echelon and other fans were unhappy with this cover because they didn't think that it was artistic enough. I thought it was brilliant. I just thought the simplicity of colour, and you can see a little bit on the back here too through the triad, the simplicity of colour. Colour is everywhere. Colour is throughout all cultures and religions. And I think the simplicity of that colour can widen your, or broaden your spectrum on what it means to you. And, you know, everyone has a colour. Everyone has, is a different person. And so it kind of represents individuality as well. So that's what I took from it. And I thought it was really cool. If you open it up, we've got the colour wheel inside here. Now, the colour wheel for me, if you've ever done psychology or read any spirituality kind of books, colour wheel represents different moods. And there's a thing in drama or acting where red, for example, is like frustration, anger, really angry, and rage. So the dark red is rage, and the blue on the other side would be feeling upset, feeling blue, sad, grief. So like as it goes in, so as an actor, I kind of took that from it. And I think that that's really cool because colour can represent all those different things. And I want to talk about this here. It's got love, lust, faith, and dreams written in different colours. Love is in red, lust is in yellow, faith is in green, and blue is dreams. Then in each song that you go through, it's got a colour next to it. So for example, with Do or Die, if I can find it on here, Do or Die is number 9. It's got a little bit of love, it's got a little bit of faith, and it's got a little bit of dreams mixed in the song. I think that's awesome. This album is so well constructed in the way that it ties all together so beautifully. If you listen to the album as a whole, a girl will come in and say love, and they'll have sections of love, lust, faith, and dreams as you go through, as you listen through it slice. So it's like a listening experience. I like albums that do that. Green Day did it with American Idiot. Tool does it in their albums. Tool is an amazing band that can do it. I like albums that flow rather than having song, 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 song. An album that flows is a listening experience. It's a soundtrack. It's amazing. Now, if we take it out, you've got front cover, and you open it up, and it's got the lyrics coming through for Do or Die, with the clouds in the up in the air and all that. And I think that's a beautiful shot. Turn the page, you've got love and the butterfly. This is photography that, you know, if you look at the up in the air videos taken from that, it's like an art experience, as Jared Leto would do. So you've got love, which, remember the elements. Lust with the snake. And then you've got the band in the middle. Tomo, Jared, and Shannon. And a really good photo. I really like that photo. You've got faith with the wolf, the black wolf. And you've got dreams with the zebra. Now, I don't know, really know what each animal would represent. But for me, love, like a butterfly, can fly away. It's beautiful, it's unknown, it's mysterious, looks very pretty. With the snake, lust. I don't like snakes. Snakes are like one of my biggest phobia. But I think snakes represent a good, have a good representation of lust, because snakes, you know, are a symbol for things, you know, Greek mythology uses snakes as a symbol for power and greed. So I think lust has a lot to do with power and greed. And I think that's probably why they chose to do a snake. The wolf for faith. For me, a wolf howling at the moon, waiting at the moon, kind of represents a kind of faith. We have a blind faith in things that we cannot see and that we think are above us. So I think that's probably why the wolf comes into faith. With the zebra for dreams. I thought long and hard about this. I'm like, why would they put a zebra on this for dreams? And I couldn't really come up with much until I started thinking about the actual fact that, I don't know whether ever anyone's heard of dreams of zebra, but like dreams of zebra can reflect the changeability in your life. So you may, like with the black and white, you may see yourself as having two distinct identities that complete your behaviour, morals or like life goals. So this is like true for people who, you know, struggle with finding an identity or like struggle with, you know, questionable ethnical places or, you know, or those who, you know, are kind of unfaithful in something. So zebra represents dreams because black and white is a representation of different things in life. And I had to actually kind of do some research to find that out, that the dreams of zebra exist. So that's an actual phenomenon, which is really cool, learning something new like that. And then on the last page, you've got just the soundboard that they would have used to produce it. Jared produces album himself, and you've just got the thanks and you know what happened and all that. All lyrics obviously are written by Jared, and Steve Lillywhite and Jared produced this. So I think that you know, Steve Lillywhite's amazing if you know anything about the albums he's produced. But yeah, he's just got a little thanks down the bottom. I'll read it to you. Thanks. Thank you for this magical life, for the unforgettable memories and for the dreams. We will never forget your support, your belief and your inspiration with gratitude and love that is taken to us. So, yeah, I love that. And I love how up here it's got photography, Jared Leto, David Delvin and Bartholomew McCubbins. Bartholomew McCubbins is Jared Leto. Like, why? Why would you put both names? Anyway. So that's the review of this album. Overall, it's got a lot of electronic, the sound of it, it's got a lot of electronic and orchestral music as opposed to their harder kind of alternative rock. But they've never stuck to a genre, and I like bands who can adapt to different sounds and experiment with new sounds, and I think that's really, really important in a world that is adapting and changing all the time, in technology, in sales, in everything. I think it's really important to adapt and expand your audience all the time. A lot of people weren't happy with this album, and I have to admit that when I first heard it, I was like, what is this? This is so different. But I'm the type of person that finds beauty in everything, so I definitely didn't wipe this album off straight away, and that's not because I just blindly follow the band either. I am wearing a Nickelback shirt, however, so that says a lot about me. I don't blindly follow anything. I have very strong beliefs in things, but this album definitely had to grow on me. I definitely had to listen to it a couple of times. I immediately fell in love with Do or Die, though. That was my favourite song on the album. I really love End of All Days. I don't like Up in the Air, for the fact that it's very electronic. It did grow on me after a while, but I still don't like it that much. I really, really like Birth. I think that's an awesome song. The Race, I have only listened to like twice. I don't really like The Race at all. City of Angels is amazing. Pyres of Varanasi is a really, really good song. Pyres of Varanasi is about the blue city in India, and it has like children in the background laughing and stuff. It just takes you to another place, and I think music that does that is really important. Bright Lights is really special to me because when I was in Paris last year, standing outside the Eiffel Tower, I was listening to Bright Lights on top of the tower, and it goes, "Bright lights, big city, she dreams of love," and it was just so special to listen to that.
This is the view from the Eiffel Tower.
Convergence I love the name for one. Convergence is when all planets align. It's called a convergence. And I think that song is really cute. It's got that, like, it's really cute. I don't really use the word cute. It's really mystical. Like, it's got a mystical kind of sound. Northern Lights is one of my favourite songs. I absolutely love Northern Lights. I love the lyrics in it. You know, so different. And it's like, you have to think about it to understand. It's very poetic, the lyrics, I think. De Pousse le De Pout, it was very unusual to have that kind of Jared singing acoustically and then have a intense, like, inception, almost music come in, and then it ends. That's the end of the album. So overall, this album is solid. It's got a great listening experience. You've got to listen to the album all the way through. Oh, I forgot a song. Conquistador. Conquistador. That song is amazing. That's a rock and roll song, Conquistador. And they definitely rock out to that. That's a good song. Overall, with the artwork, the sound, everything. It's a beautiful album. It's done really well, and probably one of the best listening experiences that I've had with an album. So I hope you guys enjoyed this review. I hope it helped the person that requested it. And I will talk to you soon. Okay, bye.